The National Assembly's Public Investment Committee invited the National Social Security Fund Management and Board to answer to queries arising from the construction of Hazina Towers. The MP is taking the chance to grill the NSSF board led by retired General Julius Karangi over delays to pay the contractor of Hazina Towers, his dues amounting to 870 million shillings.
Was the board aware in 1994 when this project was being incepted? Was the board aware? Because you said that the board was not aware. And I'm assuming now at this point we want some clarity.
It must be looked into first two phases. When it started in 1994, 1997, down there up to 2004. 2004, if you listen to a person in charge of project, said it was irrelevant at that time to start putting more efforts and more money in that project in that particular location of Nairobi. It was irrelevant. So that is why the board which was there, and if the CEO can check records, will be able to bring it to you, decided that this project stops there from 2004. Anything from that time up to this time we are talking, it's a flawed project.
The initial claim of the idling equipment at the site was 6.8 billion shillings, but was reviewed downwards to 1.8 billion shillings by a consultant hired by NSSF. The Ministry of Public Works later reviewed the figure to 870 million shillings, which the board resolved last month should be paid in order for the contractor to withdraw from the site. However, the figure is yet to be paid, thereby exposing NSSF to the risk of more fines. MPs feel there is a conspiracy to delay the claim so that it can rise.
Had this contractor agreed to that figure of 870? Had the contractor agreed? I'm assuming if he wrote to you to say that he's in agreement with that 870, but if he doesn't get paid, he'll charge penalties and interest. Is that the case, CEO?
That there seem to be, other than the board, critical board members, there seem to be other people who are calling the shot. And I was sure we were not getting an answer for it. And I feel confirmed. From the minutes, look at the minutes. Look at the minutes which I initially said on 17th, 2019. One thing I've noted with concern is that the resolutions are very ambiguous. Ambiguous. The word ambiguous should be underlined. And this is the ambiguity. The ambiguity of the minutes is one thing that is often capitalized by the management to make decisions without the full disclosure to the members of the board. The board resolved that the contractor's claim for the time lost during the project as a result of the dispute should be settled. What amount? What amount?
I want to tell this committee, if it were not for this board, there would be nothing there. This is the only board that has protected that money currently. We have a portfolio of about 235 billion and more money with fund managers currently.
The Hazina Towers project kicked off in 1994, but the board resolved to terminate it in 2004. Court Secretary General Francis Atwoli informed MPs that the decision to continue the project since 2004 was done without the board's approval. Kevin Washira, Channel One News.